Hello friends, welcome to Unity Essentials video tutorial series. From the past few video tutorials, we are trying to understand Unity User Interface, that is UI. We know that UI or user interface is a place where the application user interacts. In the previous video tutorial, we started discussing the menu bar. We understood that a menu bar typically contains various menus with list of commands to perform application related or project related or scene or document related tasks. In this video tutorial, we discuss the first menu, that is file menu. We know that file menu generally contains commands related to files. If I click on the file menu, you see various commands like new scene, open scene, save scenes, save scene as, new project, open project, save project, build settings, build and run, and exit. And you can see some of the commands are associated with shortcuts. For example, if you want to create a new scene, you need not to go to file menu and click on the new scene command. You can directly use the shortcut Ctrl N. To open a scene, you can directly use Ctrl O shortcut. We know already what is a scene, right? A scene in Unity indicates a game screen, a game level, or a film scene, or a simulation scene, right? Whenever we want to create a new game screen, new game level, a film scene, or a simulation scene, we create a new scene in Unity, right? You can see here, already we have created one scene called as first scene. And every Unity scene is considered as an asset. It is going to have the file extension .unity. You can see at present, first scene.unity is open. Every 3D project scene is going to come with two game objects, main camera and directional light. We discuss about these game objects later in the upcoming video tutorials in detail. To create a new scene, we go to file, say new scene. If I click on the new scene, you can see that Unity has created one new scene with the name untitled. Untitled means the current scene is not yet saved. We can save a scene by going to file, say save scene as. Save scene as command allows us to save the currently opened scene. If I click on save scene as command, we get a window for saving a scene. We know that every scene is an asset. We save the scene in the assets folder. So here I give the scene name as second scene. If you are creating a game level like boss level, you can give here the file name as boss level. If you are creating a welcome screen, you give the file name welcome screen. If it is a setting screen, you give a setting screen name here. Or if you are creating a climax scene in the film, you can give a file name here climax scene. I am giving here second scene for demo purpose, and every scene is going to have the file extension .unity. I click on the save button. You can see in the assets folder, we have second scene and it has the file extension .unity. At present, second scene.unity is open and it has two game objects, main camera and directional light. That is how you create a new scene. That is how you save a currently opened scene. You can open already created scenes by using this open scene command. At present, second scene is open, right? I click on the file menu. I click on open scene command. Now we get load scene window. I select the first scene to open it. I click on the open button. You see now the first scene is loaded or the first scene is open. That is how you create a new scene or save scene. Open a scene. You can make a modification to the scene, right? Once you have made the modification, you need to save them, right? For example, in the first scene, I create one 3D cube. I say game object, 3D object, say cube. Now the cube is created. You can see through the main camera. You can see there is a cube. Now we need to save this scene. To save the scene, we go to file, say save scenes. Save scenes command allows us to save the currently opened scenes. If I click on save scenes, the scene will get saved. So here we have scenes related commands, and below that we have project related commands. We know already what is a project. A project indicates a game, a movie, or a simulation. Whenever we want to create a new game, we create a new project. Whenever we want to create a new film, we create a new project in Unity. We already know how to create a new project, how to open a project. We discussed these things in the previous video tutorials, right? You can create a new project by clicking on this new project command. You can open already created projects by using this open project command. And if you want to save the currently open project, you click on the save project command. Save project command allows us to save the currently open project. Below that we have build related commands. Build settings command, build and run command. See, build settings command allows us to adjust settings for the build, and it also allows us to switch the target build platform and many other settings it provides. We know already what is a build means, right? Build indicates the final product, right? Build indicates the final product. For example, an executable file, .exe file, is the build for the Windows platform. .apk, that is Android package file, is the build for Android platform, right? If I click on this build settings, we get the build settings window. You can see here we have list of platforms. At present, the target build platform is set to PC, Mac and Linux. If I click on this build button, you see it is going to create an exe file. Let me say cancel. We can switch a platform to Android by clicking on this Android option, and then I click on this switch platform button. If I click on switch platform button, you see here in the title bar, the target build platform is changed to Android. And now if I click on this build button, it generates a file which is going to have the file extension .apk. We know that apk is the build file extension for the Android platform. Let me say cancel. Now I click on this PC, Mac and Linux. I say switch platform. You can see it is changed to PC, Mac and Linux. If I click on this build, it generates an exe file which is going to be an executable file. It also provides us the scenes to add. You can add scenes to the build. You can decide which scenes are going to be the part of the final build, like part of a game. Some of the scenes may not be part of the game. You need not to add them. Here, I'm going to add the first scene by clicking on this add open scenes. At present, first scene is open, right? If I click on add open scenes, you see first scene is added. If I want to add the second scene, I need to open the second scene and then I have to click on this add open scenes button. At present, I want only the first scene to be added to the final build. And then we click on this build button. Once I click on the build button, we get build PC Mac Linux standalone application. Here I'm going to create one folder, right click, say new folder, and I give the name as PC build. Within this folder, we put our application or the build. And here we need to give the name. If I am creating a game like shooting game, then I give here name as shooting game. If you are creating a heart simulation, you give here heart simulation, like that. I give here a first 3D project name, and if I click on this save button, it is going to save. It takes little bit time. Now the build is created. Inside the PC build folder, you see first 3D project application is created. It is an executable file, guys. If I double click on it, if it is a game, it is going to run. That is, your application is going to run actually. You see a small window. Here, you can decide the screen resolution. I decide 800 by 600 and it should be windowed. I want to see the game in the window mode, not full screen. And we can decide the graphics quality. Once I click on this play button, your game is going to run actually in the window. And you see the first scene is loaded. You can see there is a cube. So, you can give this exe file to your friends. If it is a game, they can execute and play. So that is how you create a build file, a final product, a final game, which you can distribute to the players for playing. I hope you guys have clearly understood what this build settings allows you to do. And let me close this. We also have one more command, that is build and run. Build and run command allows us to build as well as run the build on the targeted platform. We can directly build and run. For example, if I click on this build and run, if you have already adjusted the build settings, then what happens? It directly builds and runs. You get that window. You can see you got the window again. You can select the screen resolution, whether it should be windowed or not. You can decide. You can set the graphics quality. If I click on play, the game or whatever application simulation is going to play and the first scene will get loaded. Let me close it. And the last command is the exit command, which allows you to exit from the application. So if I click on exit, you see Unity application got closed. And here we have the build and application. If I double click on it, you get a window. You select the screen resolution, graphics quality, click on the play. You can see the game or a simulation, whatever you have created, is going to play. So I hope you guys have clearly understood the file menu. I think for this video tutorial this much is enough, friends. I suggest you people to watch this video again and again, understand everything clearly. In the next video tutorial we get the information about the edit menu. For more benefits and be up to date, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and don't forget to like, comment and share these videos with others so that everyone will get benefited. Keep learning, keep coding, keep sharing. Thank you guys, thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial.